Oh my goodness. Okay, from No Time to Die, we have re-recording mixer Paul Massey. Wow, Paul. So you have 223 credits to your name. Free Guy, Summer of Soul, House of Gucci, last year on No Time to Die. And you are no stranger to the world of Bond. You've worked on Quantum of Solace and Casino Royale. Talk about working with Carey, though, on this film and what he wanted to do that was different.
Well, I think on this film, because it was Daniel's last outing as Bond, there was a great deal of care taken with the emotion that he was going through and how he would exit gracefully from the franchise. As you know, it's, you know, I think the longest running franchise in history, correct? And so Barbara Broccoli and Michael Wilson, the producers, I mean, they've been long-term producers with the Bond franchise for so long, and they're very careful to maintain a certain standard of what Bond represents as history, especially in the UK. And Daniel's been there as such a great James Bond for so many years.
Yes.
Absolutely. And so I think the emotion of him discovering that he had a family, his love with Madeleine, his distrust of Madeleine earlier in the sequence that you just showed, and then, of course, the obvious action sequences that you have to have in a Bond, otherwise it wouldn't be a Bond. It was a great privilege to work on this.
Well, let's talk about that shootout in the town square and the sound that went into that, because it's bullets ricocheting off glass, it's the tires. Talk about how that came together.
Well, we had great sound supervisors in London, Oliver Tani and James Harrison, and they went through endless amounts of how to come up with that glass that was bulletproof, but convey to the audience that it wasn't going to last forever, that there was actually a threat. They had a good chance of dying. It was just a matter of time. And so they got a lot of different recordings of shards of glass that they broke with hammers and a whole slew of sounds to slowly start adding into the bullet impacts that were recorded from inside, so that you got the sense of impending danger. And Bond, at that moment, he didn't understand whether he trusted Madeleine or not, whether she was going to betray him or not. And so there was the chase that had just occurred. There was the emotion of them being, you know, they'd been T-boned, they were in a bad accident, they were pretty much immobilized in the middle of the square with this huge threat of all of these mobsters coming after them with machine guns and such. And then the moment of, should I save Madeleine or should we just let this be it? And so it had to go through that transition sound-wise. And we did that by taking a lot of the sounds in 360 degrees around the theater and introducing some that were more dramatic than others and slowly increasing the fact that the shards were breaking off from the glass, and therefore he had to make this decision very, very quickly. And then finally he goes, okay, I'm going to believe you. Let's get out of here. And off he goes. But it actually took longer than I thought it would take to get through that sequence, just because of the emotion of it, not just because of the physicality of what was going on.
Yeah. In contrast, talk about shooting like the sound for the car chase with all the Land Rovers over the Swedish bridge. You know the scene that I'm talking about, right?
Yeah, in Norway. I mean, I actually wasn't part of the recording of the sound effects, so I'm in charge of the dialogue and music mixing that you hear in the final product. That sequence there was obviously an adrenaline-driven car chase with a lot of threat, a lot of danger, rolling Land Rovers, rocks, mud, dirt, helicopters, motorbikes. And then somewhere I had to fit Hans Zimmer's score in there, otherwise he would have been mad at me. No, I've worked with Hans on several films, and I thought he did an incredible job of bringing this score and the themes up until...
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, thank you.
Yes.
Well done, Hans. So for us as mixers throughout that sequence, there was the adrenaline of what needed to be an action-packed sequence, especially in the first half of it. And then it had to turn around, and we couldn't just sustain it with sound effects and loud revving engines and machine guns. We didn't want to assault the audience for that long. So we carefully picked a point where Hans's score could actually break the barrier and appear above the cloud. And let the sound effects drift down. And that was when they were coming down the hill, the motorbikes were chasing them, cars were bouncing all over the place, the helicopter was flying by. And at that moment, we brought Hans's theme forward, and that took us out of that sequence into the woods, where it got really quiet.
You worked on Ford v Ferrari. Compare recording, you know, a car chase there, when they're zooming around the track to, you know, No Time to Die. Like, what's the difference? I mean, they're completely different films, but...
Yeah, good question. I've worked with Jim Mangold, the director, on Ford v Ferrari on about, I think about 8 or 9 films. And so I think the difference for me as a re-recording mixer, mixing dialogue and music, is that with Carrie, who I really enjoyed working with and learned a great deal from for No Time to Die, it was my first experience with him. So there's always a little bit of feeling each other out and figuring out what his taste really is and what he's looking for. With Jim, it's like a shorthand for me because I've worked with him so many times before. So I knew what he wanted in terms of once you get out onto the racetrack, and he wanted that adrenaline, but he didn't want to lose the music. But he likes to really mash up the music as well. So we'll have infinite control of almost every single instrument in the score. And he's constantly moving things around sync-wise and different types of instrument to highlight at different times. Might be drums, might be rhythm guitar, might be... And he's constantly, as we're mixing, moving things around and everything stays fluid. Finally, you lock in and... I love that process with him because we've done it so many times. It's fun.
Incredible. Paul, stay put. We are now going to pull up a clip from Spider-Man No Way Home.